Good morning, my dear students. Welcome you all. We have studied about the verb. And verb is what? It is an action word. And then we saw the various types and forms of the verbs also. So that verb we know. But actually, what is finite verb and what is infinite verbs? So let us today we will see infinite verbs and finite verbs. So see here, non-finite verbs. If today we are going to learn about this non-finite verb, means what? So it is nothing but infinitives. First is infinitive and second participles. Various participles are there, that we call non-finite verb. But before seeing that non-finite verb, let us know about a finite verb. What is a finite verb? Then we come to know what is non-finite verb or what is infinitive or what is participle. To know the infinitive and participle, we should have to know about the finite verb first. So see, a finite verb changes its forms in order to indicate a change in sentence, in tense or subject. Tense, you know that? That if I said he, ate, he, eat. So, you can imagine maybe it is present tense. But if I said ate, then you can understand it is a past tense. Means it get changed, eat get changed. So, that is finite verb. That finite verb can change its form in order to indicate the change in the tense. Isn't it? See here. Then, see the examples. How the finite verb get changed. First one, I sing a song. What is the verb here? Sing is the verb. See, I sing a song. Then, Monu sings a song. What is the change? S is here. That S is get changed. S is extra given there to the sing. Then Monu and I sang a song. No sing, sang is there. Means sing, sings, sang. Then another, we will sing a song. What is the tense here? Future tense, past tense and present tense. To know the tense, like our definition is given here. To show out or to indicate the changes in the tense of the subject, that finite verb is used. That till here we use the finite verb, means the main verb in the sentence which show us changes into the tense. Now see, what is non-finite verb then? What is? So, a non-finite verb is a verb. See, what is it? It is also a verb. Does not change its forms like as, like past form or the future form. That is, we can say it does not change. It is very important. Does not change its forms to indicate a change in the tense or subject like this. Here we saw that for the present tense it is, for the past tense and for the future tense we will see it is there. But here there are no changes like this. That's why it is a non-finite verb. So see here, there are three kinds of non-finite verb. How many kinds? Three kinds of non-finite verbs are there. Three kinds. So the first one is to verb. That is infinitive. To plus V1. Very important, it is V1. Always it is V1. You saw that. I want to see television. But you never speak like that. I want to saw. That to saw, that to open ed and en, that is not, it is wrong. So what is right? V1. 2 plus V1. That is very important. So 2 plus verb, that is infinitive. What we say that 2? If 2 is there before the non-finite verb, then it is infinitive. See, asleep tries to write. He is trying only. Trying. It is main verb. That is finite verb. It is what? Finite verb. And it is infinite verb. Finite verb, infinite. Infinite, no change. See, then it is for present tense. Now past. Asir tried. See, tries and tried. Past tense. To write. Same it is. To write. No change like to wrote. So it is, though it is the past tense, but no change into the infinitive. 2 plus V1. Then you can see also future. It is also like that. Asim will try to write. To write is same. And will try, it is the tense, that is finite verb. You can write it is finite verb and it is non-finite verb. It is what? Non-finite verb or infinite verb. See here, the next non-finite verb is present participle. Means that infinitive and participles we are going to see. So the present participle, it is what? It is always V1 plus ing. V1, always V1 plus ing. See, eating, we write like eating. Writing, we write like writing. But we never like write roting. Is there? No, it is wrong. 18. Suppose it is past tense and into past we want to ing. 18. No, it is wrong. So what we use here? We use here was eating. But that it is V1 plus ing. Here also writing. Was writing. Was writing. That is V1 ing. Isn't it? So that is present participle. Asit is writing. Asit was writing. Writing is same. Will be writing. Present, past, future. Now see ed form. Next, that is past participle. Past means present ing, but past ed or en. Ed or en verbs. Means many verbs we saw, that V1, V2, V3, while we see the forms of the verbs. So that time ed and en is given there. So for example, see, Asit has written. What is there? Asit has written. That is past participle. But has is the finite verb and it is infinite verb. Asit had written. Asit will have written. En, ed. Suppose stop is there. So we should use ed to the non-finite verb. So these are the types of non-finite verbs, like to be, ing, or en or ed. So you have to keep in your mind one thing, that non-finite verb can never be used by itself in the sentence, because a sentence must have a finite verb. Must have. Here is a finite verb, here is finite verb. Here it is finite verb. Then after, the non-finite verb is there. And that non-finite verb or the infinitives you see here, that never get changed. It should be like the formula. 2 plus V1. V1 plus ing. And whatever the past participle is given there, always it is V3. It is V3. So these are the non-finite verbs. Three kinds of non-finite verbs today we saw. Thank you.